so many people suffering with trying to make their utility payments at this time. Tell us your name.
Sierra Gibson.
Sierra, is your utility off?
Not right now.
Oh, but it's about to be?
Disconnection. Mm-hmm.
How did you end up in this situation?
I was incarcerated and just coming back home, you know, in my own place and getting everything transferred into my name, so.
And so you're facing the shutoff. Mm-hmm. And how much do you need to raise right now?
Like $800.
$800. Mm-hmm. How do you keep hope alive?
Just by having faith and being strong.
Just continue to keep trusting God day by day. Mm-hmm. Well, while you're here, New Life Evangelistic Center is also going to help acquaint you with different forms of renewable energy, like mm-hmm. solar cookers, alternative ways of trying to heat your home, ways that you can try to keep your electric bill down, your gas bill down. Mm-hmm. You ready to learn?
Yes.
That's what we want to do. We're giving people a hand up, not just a hand out. And I'm asking you right now to continue to keep us in your prayers here at the New Life Evangelistic Centers. We're working to be there when people are hurting.
One thing that you all have in common is that you're all here for some sort of energy assistance. Okay? I'm going to start off by saying what you want to do is be better energy consumers. If your energy consumption is consistently exceeding on a monthly basis what you can actually afford to pay for, well, that's poor energy consumption, okay? But more importantly, that's poor financial management. Now, the reason why I gave you some of these, the pamphlets here, was just a home checklist for action, just little ways, tips that you can lower your energy footprint, okay? Because what you want to do, you want to nickel and dime your way to a more financially manageable level of energy consumption. Does that make sense to everybody? Okay, one way that you can do that, we'll start with one of my rooms that I have down the solar hot water tank, is the temperature of your hot water heater. Okay, this pamphlet here on the back page, you don't realize you're all here for Ameren. Whether you have a gas heater or an electric heater, even with a gas heater, you still have an electric ignite. Okay, with a gas heat water heater, utilizing two energy sources, you know, gas and that electricity. 14%, and this is just an average, 14% of your utility bill monthly is spent, and that's just the average. It could be different for every household. It could be 20%, 18% for you, 16% for you, but the average is 14% of your energy cost is your energy expenditures is for, silence your phones please, is for keeping your hot water tank hot, water in your hot water heater hot. That's 14% of your monthly bill, okay? And that's, think about how often you use hot water, you know. What you wanna do is you wanna turn that thermostat down to 120 degrees. That is the energy saving setting, okay?
I'm here from getting help from Reverend Ross, I didn't even know you were helping since you moved from 14th. And I, as it happened, I called. I got a referral from St. Vincent de Paul and need a little help. My daughter got laid off and she's going to school. And I thank God for you, you know, giving me help on my utility bill today.
Well, yes, we're.
And I have asthma, by goddess.
We are definitely on the front lines right now because of all of you that are sharing. New Life Evangelistic Center, yes, is working to get back into 1411 Locust, but we have a complete energy center. We're set up at 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri, where individuals are getting assistance on the utility bills, and they'll also be taking some tours as far as discovering the world of renewable energy. And who is this right here?
This is my my daughter's at school, so trying to get a degree. She graduates mm-hmm. in December, thank the Lord. Yeah. My granddaughter, 3-year-old Cameron Hall.
All right. And what utility are you struggling with?
Utility, all electric.
All electric.
So if that gets shut off, nothing.
Wow. It seems like this puts some stress
yes,
on you.
Yes, it does. It does.
Tell me, how do you keep moving? How do you keep going?
Just volunteering, praying with the help of the good Lord, helping out a friend of mine, well, was helping her with her mother, but her mother's in the hospital with home care, so that cuts out a lot
right,
of
let
the,
me show you some of the things you're going to see today yeah. to try to help you save on your electric
yes,
bill.
Sir.
You're going to learn about solar cooking, okay?
Okay.
And they're also going to show you how to make a canned heater, all right? Yeah, so you don't have to, don't plug in any more electric space heaters, okay?
I'm scared of those.
All right, well here, look, see, this has got a little candle in
okay.
here, okay? And it's got some sand.
Yes, sir.
And that's inside a gallon can, Then you take another can, punch the holes in, and put it in like that.
Okay.
And you put it, and then you light it. So this protects like the little ones and the rest of them from doing it. And also, it gives off some heat. And it's not going to make your electric bill go up.
Yes, sir. Oh, that is wonderful.
So they're showing you some of that because everyone that gets assistance from us, they go on a tour here of all different kinds of renewable energy.
Every positive resources is greatly appreciated.
Well, we want to try to help. So they got a number of these different things that they'll be showing you in a little while, in addition to solar power and all different kinds of renewable energy. Because as I indicated, New Life Evangelistic Center, we're giving the folks hand up. Just a handout. We're trying to show them how they can help themselves, and they also get into a lot of savings, how to save money. We call it kill a watt, instead of kilowatt. Use less and less electricity.
Yes, sir.
It's like going to the grocery store and filling your grocery cart. Budget. Think about, hey, what do I turn off the lights?
Yes.
How can I turn down the thermostat? Yes. What can I do to save? Because if you were at a grocery store and you just filled it all up with food you can order and they got to the checkout stand, then you couldn't pay for it. And so you do the same thing with electricity. You get the bill at the end of the month. You can't pay it. It's going to get shut off.
Yes.
So let's learn how to budget our electricity.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to help people be energy independent, and that's all possible because of those of you that are praying, caring, and sharing now with the New Life Evangelistic Center.
Also, you want to check to see if your water heater has an insulating blanket. The reason for this being, you've already gone the extra 9 yards to turn it down to the energy-saving level. Hot water heater is basically just a big thermos bottle, okay? It's a glass bottle encased in aluminum that's wrapped in stainless steel, all right? Metal is not very conducive to retaining heat, so by wrapping it in that the blanket, you're just giving yourself an extra leg up on keeping that temperature confined to your hot water tank. You don't want to overwork that thermostat. Every time it has to kick in, it's drawing an energy source, okay?
Hello, I'm Ashley Smith, and this is an energy conservative. It's pretty cool.
It's what they call a canned heater. And as I was showing the other lady, there's a candle inside this little can.
Uh-huh.
And then you have that. And the reason for the sand is because when you heat all this, that's like mass. It kind of helps hold the heat in there. And you get a fruit can, punch all these holes in them. You stick that over that right there. And then you can, when you light the candle, it starts giving off the heat.
Oh, okay, that's cool.
And that way you don't have to use all those electric heaters.
Uh-huh, okay.
Now tell me, you're facing the shutoff of your utility right now?
Yes, I am. Just having a lot of financial problems right now, so I need some assistance. And Reverend Wright's, I heard about him through a family member, and so he's here to help. I don't have problems all the time, but, you know, everybody goes through problems, so yeah.
How do you keep going when you go through problems?
For me, I just pray, keep faith, and that's about it. Give it all to God and leave it there. So,
okay, tell us, how does prayer help you?
Prayer, it gives you power. It makes you feel like, you know, someone's there listening. So that's how it helps me. When I pray, I feel better afterwards, so.
Well, yes, and often you think of prayer. You could actually, I've got two formulas. One is spell out the word acts, adoration, you adore God. You just praise him. Mm-hmm. Confession may be things in our life we need to confess before him. Thanksgiving is thanking him for all that he's done. And the S is the supplication, asking.
Okay.
Or you can think of another way, like you're writing a note. Dear Father, and just talk to him, okay?
Uh-huh. Okay.
Another one is, I need help. Tell them what you need.
Uh-huh.
Another one is, they need help. Talk about others that you know that may need help, intercessor, okay?
Uh-huh.
And then finally, just go into thanking him. Just say, thanks, Lord, for all doing this and this, developing an attitude of gratitude.
Uh-huh. That's right.
So there's power in prayer. You know, Jesus' disciples didn't say, Lord, show us how to do miracles, Lord, how to multiply loaves. Lord. They said, Lord, teach us how to pray, because they saw the power of prayer in Jesus' life.
Mm-hmm.
There's power in prayer. Now, it's very important also to immerse your prayers into the Word of God. Do you have a Bible?
Yes, I do have a Bible.
You read it.
Not often.
Just having it there and not reading it is like having a refrigerator full of food and never eating.
Right, right.
You got to read it.
Okay.
You say, well, what do I read? You can read the Psalms. Mm-hmm. You can read the Gospel of John. You can read Romans. I mean, there's just a lot of places in the Scripture.
Uh-huh.
And so he says, ask, it shall be given you. Seek, and you'll find. Knock, and shall be opened unto you. Well, we have to be able to also, you know, let the Word of God take root in our life and begin to pray the Word.
Yes, sir, that's right.
The energy-saving settings on your refrigerator. Also, if you don't have one of the Energy Star refrigerators, you want to have that little knob that goes from like 1 to, to 10. Okay, you should have that setting at 5, never above or never below 5. And the reason for this is very, very simple. The food danger zone is between 40 and 140 degrees, okay? The temperature inside your refrigerator is never going to go above 38. It's never going to drop below 33. And we all know 32 is freezing, right? Let's say, for example, you have it set at anywhere from 7 upwards. Or let's say you got it jacked all the way up to 10. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever gone in your refrigerator and you have little ice crystals in your milk? That ever happened to you? Yeah. Or your grapes are a little harder than they should be? Well, it's just turned up too high. And it's almost at the freezing level, okay? That's a waste of energy, all right? Dial that down to the 5 setting, okay? Your refrigerator is never going to go above 40. It's never going to drop below 33. Any setting over 5, you're wasting energy, okay? And you know, if you're wasting energy, you're wasting money.
My name is Veronica Claiborne, and I'm here to get some assistance for electric, because me and my children been in the dark for about a month, and this seems like this was the only resort for me.
So your electricity's actually off?
Yes.
Wow, you've been in the dark for a month. How you making it?
I'm just making it day by day. Asking God to pour a blessing down on me and my children.
Okay, they're gonna show you ways of trying to save money on your utility bill. Okay, now here's something you could do with the children. What, you know what this is? This is a canned heater. And what they do is they fill these with sand, and they actually can put them in the window, and where it faces the sun, and it catches the sun. It's heat. And then what we do is we could put a little fan down here and actually blow it out. So I'm going to show you about that while you're here. They'll show you also about another type of canned heater they use a candle in. And then behind us over here, we have solar cooking. So just some things we can do. First of all, if it's totally off, wow, you're going to have to set up a particular room to just kind of be able to try to stay warm in, and maybe use the canned heaters they'll be showing you over there about, okay, with the candle in it. Now, how much is your bill?
They're requiring $618, but the total is like $800.
Wow, how did it get that big?
I don't know. Maybe it needed some meter change or something. I don't know.
So it's totally off now. How many children are in there?
2.
2, and how old are they?
14 and 12.
Okay. While you're here today, be sure you pick up some blankets. Learn everything you can about safe ways of being able to be warm. We're going to help you some towards your bill, okay? Use that now to try to, try other places. Have you tried other places?
Yes, I tried Community Action Agency.
What did they tell you?
They denied me.
Why?
I have no idea.
They may not be releasing any funds till the middle of November, okay? That may be the whole reason. So don't give up. Just continue to keep on praying to it. I know it's hard. I know it's hard, but don't give up. God is right there with you. And we're going to try to help you some toward that today, okay? And just continue. If somebody saw this and wanted to help you further, is there a way they could get in touch with you?
Yes.
How's that?
Through my telephone.
And what would that be? Your number?
445-8852.
445-8852. Is that it? And tell them your name again.
Veronica Claiborne.
Veronica. We're giving you an opportunity to help, to team up with someone right now. Veronica here, her electric is off. They're in the dark. We want to help them. And we're just asking you to just please keep Veronica in your prayers at this time. She's not alone. There's so many that are facing the shutoff right now. A lot of people facing the shutoff with utilities. So we're going to show them some alternatives at this time. And I'm asking you to please help us to help those that are in need.
As you can see here, we have solar cookers. These are built down in New Bloomfield, Missouri. And all of these are for sale also. I'm not here to sell anybody anything. I have literature here if you'd like to take one of these for free. Has anybody ever used a solar cooker before? Okay, well, the basic principle of a solar cooker, and it's just what it says here, you're taking the energy from the sunlight and applying it to this apparatus that cooks your food, okay? Basically, you would think of this as, actually this one here can reach internal temperature of between 350 and 400 degrees with direct sunlight. So the same application that you could utilize your oven with in your home, you could, as the pictures imply here, they've done casseroles, you can do cookies in here, brownies, bake a chicken, you know, it will take approximately the same amount of time to do that. That smaller unit back there, that one would probably reach an internal temperature between 150 and 200 degrees. That one is more along the lines of your crock pot. It'll take a little longer, but it'll get the job done. And actually, that's the one that I take on tour whenever I do outside venues or events or whatever. And we'll put hot dogs or bratwurst or whatever in there to show that it's a practical application. You're not using any charcoal, any electricity. You don't have to buy lighter fluid. It's all from the energy of the sun. Okay.
Hi, my name is Jackie, and my electricity is currently off. I was in a car accident 3 months ago, and thank God I'm alive. I had not been able to pay my bill since then because I have not been working since then. I have two daughters. One has been helping me religiously pay my rent and keep me above water. So my electricity's been off. On the nice days, I open my blinds and let the sun beam in, and it gets warm, and I'm able to stay there those nights. But other nights, I just either stay with one of my daughters or the other.
So you're really making a go of it at this time, right? Truly trying.
Basically.
All right. Part of our assistance program here at 2428 Woodson Road at the New Life Evangelistic Center is to give people a hand up. So along with energy assistance, we also show them alternative energy methods. So as we're going through this here today, you're going to be seeing different ways of trying to make it right now. You mentioned on warm days. What do you do on a cold day? Obviously, you can't plug in. They're going to be showing you the canned heater. They also have it in a clay pot here, okay? They'll show you how to use the clay pot, and it stands up right here. There's a candle under there. A candle goes right under there. It heats up. And another way that one that you can maybe work is with the canned heater right here. See there? You got a little can with a candle in it.
Oh, okay.
Then you put holes in that, and you put this over it. And put a number of these in a room, and this can actually serve like a number of space heaters, only no electricity.
Mm, okay.
So these are some of the things that they'll be showing you here. How much is your bill?
Currently, it's
$810. $810, and they shut you off.
Yes, part of that, first of all, I just got my apartment July 1st. The accident was 19 days later. Mm-hmm. So when Ameren turned me on, I had a previous bill that they transferred, which was like $400. So of the $800, like $400 of it is from a previous bill. Okay. And I had made arrangements to pay my regular bill plus $57 a month towards this previous bill. Those were the arrangements that I made with them. I couldn't fulfill those arrangements because I was in a car accident. They had to cut me out of the car, jaws of life. So I'm just thankful to be here.
You're thankful. How do you keep going day after day?
What keeps you going?
Pray.
How does prayer help you?
Immensely.
Does it really? Gives you the strength? What if you didn't believe in God, what would happen to you?
I wouldn't be here. There's no such thing as not believing because he spared my life.
You know he spared your life.
I know he did. And I don't know what my assignment is, but I know he has something for me. I should have been dead. The way I was, I mean, I should have been dead. I have a scar on my leg.
Yes.
I can show you guys. That right. Goes from here all the way up my head.
Okay. All right. So, if people want to help you further, is there a number they can get in touch with you at?
Yeah, they can call my cell phone.
What is that?
314-339-9157.
314-339-9157. If they want to help you further.
If they want to help me further.
And we're asking you to please help this lady and so many others that are coming to us right now at the New Life Evangelistic Center so we can continue to be there when the people are hurting through the love of Jesus. How I thank God for those of you that are sharing with the New Life Evangelistic Center so we can help her today. It's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. And give them your name again so they can hold you up before the Lord.
My name is Jackie, last name Faint.
Please remember Jackie in your daily prayers.
I would have to look up the conversions for the pricing, rather, for the solar hot water conversion. But you think about it, especially if you own your own home, just that expense taken away alone, you figure your average 14% on a monthly basis, and that's just a broad generalization, it could be more, you're taking that completely out of the equation as an expenditure, converting over to a solar hot water system just on your hot water tank alone.
Excuse me, but yes. You have to still have the solar panel outside, right?
Yes, it would be roof mounted, or if it would be more convenient for you, you could also do a vertical pole mounted panel system in your backyard. When you do that, you have to think about shading. We would have to do an assessment and look to see where trees are would be blocking, because if you have any shading on any part of the solar panel itself, it's not getting 100% of the rays from the sun to create that electricity. But generally for a solar hot water system, it would be a roof mount system.
My name is Sade Snufke. The problem I'm facing right now with my utility bill is I was taking care of my father-in-law. He was disabled. And I became power of attorney over him with my husband, and we pretty much got all of his bills. So my electric bill for my first month in my house was over $2,000. So I'm just going around trying to get help for my electric bill so I won't get it cut off on the 5th.
Okay, they're going to give you a tour here today to also show you how to save money on utility bill, because that's a very high utility bill.
Yeah.
And we're just really going to try to show you that you need to implement some of these things, okay, to really cut down your electrical usage. How did you find out about this place?
My sister, she does leasing, and she gave me a list of utility assistant places. So I contacted them, and they told me to come in.
All right, we're going to be taking you on a class here in just a few minutes, okay?
Okay.
If you already have an electric water tank, that application would be simple. It would just be the conversion or adding the solar panel, the converters, and the power generators and everything you would need for that application. It would have to be a certified technician that would have to come in and do that. But you see, this is a demonstration of a multi-solar system, which has a couple of rooms. Your hot water is going to different rooms in your home, your washer, doesn't see the kitchen here, but you see where I'm going with this, that application. You are taking that expense completely out, 100% of your electrical equation, for as long as you have this system incorporated to your hot water tank. Now, the ministry doesn't sell this conversion kit per se. If you were to call my office, I do know of different solar companies here in the Missouri area that would be able to accommodate you. But the reason why this just give you something to think about, especially if you own your own home, that this system is applicable if you are ever considering that type of conversion for your home. And you remember, as I said before, how often you use hot water determines what percentage that increase is going to be on your monthly bill, because it's at least you're spending 14% of that is directed strictly for keeping your water hot.
Hey, Ms. Lynn Reddit, and right now I need some utility assistance with my system. I'm also a disabled veteran, and to the point that that's what got me here in the first place. They are starting to make me pay for my medicine, which I don't have, being disabled.
You're a disabled veteran. Mm-hmm. We try to help a lot of veterans, whether they're homeless and they're suffering utility shutoffs. How did you hear about this place?
Reverend Larry Cook.
Pastor Cook told you to come here. Mm-hmm. And they're going to be giving you a tour. And as you see this tour, you're going to have a chance to learn how to save money, utility bill, alternative energy choices. A lot of different ways to try to cut back on that.
Right.
They're about ready to shut you off, you said.
That is correct.
All right. Well, we're going to try to help this gentleman, and there's so many others that are coming to us, and the only way we can help them is because of all of you that are praying, caring, and sharing this time. They're going to show you about how to create solar cookers here, how to create window heaters, can heaters, just a lot of different ways to cut back on the utility service, and, of course, insulation.
Okay.
All right. We thank God for all of you that make it possible for us to be able to help those that are in need.
Anyone have any questions or anything? Yes.
So the solar is actually works from the sun, right?
Yes.
So what if there's no sun? Then will it still work, or will it still make the water higher?
Well, generally on a system like this, you would be grid tied.
Okay.
Yes. So say, for example, you have the switch that you could just go solar. You could shut that off completely on days like when it's overcast or whatever. You hit that switch. Now you're back on utilizing Ameren. Yeah, you have to be grid tied with this type of system. However, like on a bright sunny day, clear day, you can take Ameren out of it completely. And let's say you get a week or 3 weeks of sunshine. You're taking Ameren out of that equation for those days. Now, on the days when, that was a very good question. Thank you. Yeah, on the days when it's overcast, and especially like if it's winter or whatever, of course, you're going to have to incorporate Ameren more often than you would, say, spring through early fall. But all of that sunlight that you get spring through early fall, boom, you're taking Ameren out of the equation for a good 80% of that time. And think about how much money that would be able to save. Yeah.
My name is Hannah Yakubu.
Okay, you are about to have your electric shut off?
Yeah.
Wow. Who told you about New Life Evangelistic Center?
A friend from work.
They told you about that?
Yes.
And were you glad when they said come?
Yes, I was glad when they said come. Yeah.
Now they're going to be showing you, and they are showing you, all different kinds of forms of renewable energy. Are you excited about learning that?
Yes, I am.
And how would that help you?
Oh, I think that would help me greatly to get by on my feet.
Okay, look, they show you how to cook outside. This is what they call a solar cooker back behind us here, okay?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
It's one of a number of them. Mm-hmm. You think you'd like to learn how to do that?
Yes, I do.
You know, they've even done solar cooking when there's snow on the ground, as long as the sun is shining in there.
Mm-hmm.
So they teach you how to do that. And you ask a lot of questions, as the man shows you, okay?
Okay.
And we thank God for all of you that make it possible. New Life Evangelistic Center, giving people a hand up, not just a handout, teaching them to help themselves, use their God-given talents, and learn how to use the sun. So please continue to pray for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center, whether it's the sun or the wind or all different kinds of renewable energy, energy savings. Yes, we want to continue to be there when the people are hurting.
Anybody have any other questions? Okay, ladies. Yes,
ma'am. Can we get pamphlets on any of this?
Actually, I can make copies. All you have to do is just call up here. They'll direct you to my office. I would get your mailing address, you know, and I'll ship this out to you free. Yeah,
okay.
But it's on the table here. The solar hot water system. Actually, this is the manual, but it's under your purse right here. And I can make, design and installation manual. I can make, I'm Damon Williams.
Okay.
And I'll get you my contact information and on your way out. But yes, if you are ever interested in something like that, you just call the number that you call for your utility assistance and ask for Dave Williams. They'll connect you to my office. I'll get your mailing address, and I can send you any literature that you think you might be interested
Great.
In.
My name's Julie.
And Julie, tell me, you're here today. Why are you facing needs?
Because I'm just about to get shut off, if not getting shut off today.
Have you been shut off before?
Yes, in the past.
Wow. So how does it come to this point?
I'm disabled, and I struggle paying the bills with my disability check.
I see you have a cross on, a rosary.
Yes, I do. I believe in God, and I believe God helps us.
How does it help you as you pray?
Because God solves everyone's needs, and if it wouldn't be for God, I wouldn't have found you.
Well, we thank God for those of you that are letting God's light and love flow through you, and the answer to people's prayers that you are Amen. As you support the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. How I thank God for each one of you that are praying, caring, and sharing at this time.